Welcome to a video on how to determine the value of a derivative function at a given point. So for example, if we're given this function, we can find the value of the derivative function at these points on the graphing calculator. Remember, the graphing calculator will not find the derivative function, but it can evaluate it at a given value of x. Let's go ahead and switch to our graphing calculator. There are two ways to do this. Let's go ahead and talk about the way we can do it from the home screen first. If we press the math key and then scroll down to option 8 and derive will evaluate the derivative function at a given value of x. So we press enter. Next we type in our given function, which is x cubed divided by 4 minus 3x. Next, we press comma above the 7. Then we press the variable that we're using, which is x, comma, and then the x value we're considering. So the first point was 0, 0. We type in only the x value of x equals 0. Close the parenthesis and press enter. Now, we have to notice that the graphing calculator is not going to get the exact value all the time. We need to recognize this value as negative 3. Let's go ahead and record that, and then we'll come back to do the other two. So what we just found was that f prime of 0 is equal to negative 3. Now we'll find the value of the derivative at these points. Remember, to do that, we only need to evaluate the derivative at the given values of x, so 2 and then 4. Instead of typing all this in again, what we can do is press second enter, and then just scroll over here and change the 0 to a 2. Press enter. Again, the calculator is having a little bit of difficulty here. This is 2.5 times 10 to the negative 7th, which is very close to 0. And in fact, that is the value of the derivative at x equals 2. So f prime of 2 is equal to 0. And lastly, we'll consider the derivative function when x equals 4. So again, we'll press second, enter, change this 2 to a 4. And again, we'll recognize this as f prime of 4 is equal to 9. Remember, the derivative measures the rate of change of y with respect to x, and it would also be the slope of the tangent line. So if we take a look at the function when x equals 0, the slope of the tangent line should be negative 3. If we were to sketch a tangent line right here, that does look like a line that has slope of negative 3. F prime of 2 equals 0 means that x equals 2, the slope of the tangent line should be 0, or we'd have a horizontal tangent line. And it looks like we do. And at x equals 4, the derivative function is equal to 9, which means on our original function at x equals 4, the slope of the tangent line should be equal to 9. And it looks like it is. I want to show you one other way we can do this on the graphing calculator. If we press y equals and type in the function into y1, and then in y2 we're going to type in the notation for the derivative function evaluated at x. So we'll press math 8. Our function is y1, so we'll press vars, yvars, enter, enter, comma, our variable x, comma, we want to evaluate this derivative at any value of x, so we'll press x again and then close the parenthesis. Press enter. Now if we go to table set for a moment, second window, make sure that we have our independent variable on ask, and then go to the table, press second graph. Now we can type in any value of x we want, and y1 is the function value, and y2 would be the derivative function value. So notice this verifies our work. The derivative at x equals 0 is equal to negative 3. At 2, it's equal to, remember this is very close to 0, 2.5 times 10 to the negative 7th. And then at 4, the derivative function was equal to 9. Lastly, if we wanted to, if we could press graph, it'll graph the original function, and it'll also graph the derivative function. Now, it does take some time, there we see it. And what I want you to notice here is, remember, our original function was a degree 3 function. And we know when we apply the power rule for differentiation, the derivative will be a degree 2 function, as we see here in the shape of a parabola. Okay, that'll do it for this video. Thank you for watching.